Okay, here's another vid. This is going to be a good example of how to create a horizontal channel. It's pretty easy, specifically with Sellers EA, because as soon as you click on the breakout, it puts it up right away, and you just got to adjust it up or down wherever you want it. But anyway, the previous vid, I did a little test on a short at the top here. I just closed it down. This is a demo, of course, but I just wanted to show you how you can trade that and then watch the trade unfold, how it came down, broke the 4 hour, came back and tested it. Pretty quick test. I really don't like those too much. I like it to come down and break it and find its way around and go back and test it again. On the previous vid before last Friday's, I think it was, or Thursday, when this started to happen, we got this big spike down. When this happens, that's a little sketchy because I don't know what was causing this. There was no news, so no clue. And I suggested then that we could break this, come down, test it, break through the 4 hour, wander around a little bit, and possibly test it again, which of course we did. But I also stated that I took a short trade live right here on this candle. This was aggressive. But I just did it. As long as you have a stop loss in place, there's nothing wrong with being aggressive. And I still have my rules. It did come down, break through the 4 hour, come back up and test it quickly, which I don't typically like. And then the has obviously turned. The CCI was already there. So I took it. My first stop was right here, this little higher high. And then as it moved down into profit, I moved it to right here. So my stop was there. Still wasn't at break even, but I don't typically use break even. I just bring them down to higher highs and or whatever, lower lows, whatever the case may be. And then this morning when I woke up, it took me out. Minimal loss, but stop loss was there. And from the get-go, it was an aggressive trade for me, or my style of trading with the channels. But anyway, here's the new setup that I'm currently going to follow. And this will be a perfect example of how to use Sellers breakout lines. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create the breakout lines, and I'm going to keep this one right here and then put this one at the top of my channel, my daily channel. And that's how I'll set that up. And then one quick thing I want to, to go over to make it clear is drawing this channel. When you need 2 points of contact, that's my rule anyway, you also need it to be a little wider than what I was showing before. And that's over time you get to notice these things and get used to it. Like you can't really trade this. For one, you got this crazy candle. No idea what that was about. So that's your first heads up. Something's weird. But you can't trade with these 2 points of contact. It's just too tight. And at the same time you're drawing this, you can look at these candles right here. And what is it doing? It's going horizontal. The bodies are pretty thin. So right away, you just have to be patient and wait if you're looking for this diagonal channel. But what I do, obviously, is what I just showed you. And that's what I'll be trading live, is horizontal channel. Go long at the top, go short at the bottom, and in this case it just so happens when that, as you saw, when you place his breakout lines on, Sellers breakout lines, it's pretty much going, they line up pretty close to going out on my daily and breaking the top of the horizontal channel, pretty close. But anyway, that's my setup and a follow-up to last week, to my live trade. And I hope this helps using Sellers breakout lines to create these trades off the channels, or just a simple trend line. Once you get really good at it, and you got a sense of direction where you want to trade, you can just trade a trend line. You don't necessarily have to have a channel. The channel just makes it look nicer. It's quick to see which way the trend is, but after you get used to doing it a few times, you can simply just know which way you should be trading and put one trend line in. But anyway, hope this helps you. I'll try to make another one to follow up on the current trade.